In this video, I'll be covering the basics of the DynaMesh menu, as well as explaining the relationship between object size and DynaMesh resolution. Hello, and welcome to a video about DynaMesh basics. What we're going to do is take this gorilla head and turn it into more of a stylized headdress using the power of DynaMesh. You can use DynaMesh in any number of ways. The first way we're going to use it is by using a ZBrush primitive. So what I'm going to do is go out of edit mode and hit Control N to clear my canvas. Grab the simple brush, and in the simple brush menu, go ahead and grab the cylinder 3D. I'm going to drag that out into my canvas, go back into edit mode, and because it's a ZBrush primitive, I have access to this initialize menu down at the bottom of the tool menu. I'm going to open that up, and in order to get a nice smooth profile on these edges, what I'm going to do is crank this H divide up to about 89. I'm going to decrease the Z size to kind of flatten out that profile, and I'm going to taper the top just a little bit just to make it a little bit more interesting. Once I'm happy with the shape that I have, in order to make this sculptable, what I need to do is go to the top of the tool menu and hit the Make Polymesh 3D button. Now I'm able to go in here and sculpt on and move things around as I would a normal tool in ZBrush. And you may have noticed as I was sculpting on this object, as I got towards the middle, it started acting a little erratically. And the reason for that is because when I turn on Polyframe, the ZBrush primitive actually gave us two polarized caps on either side. So these long, thin triangles aren't doing us any favors while we're trying to sculpt. What you want is nice, evenly spaced quads, kind of like what we have up here at the top, but over the whole object. And a quick and easy way to get those nice, evenly spaced quads is by using the power of DynaMesh. So I'm going to Control Z out of those, and we're going to scroll down until we get to the Geometry menu. And towards the middle bottom here is the DynaMesh section. So with our object selected, Polyframe turned on, I'm just going to hit this DynaMesh button with the defaults. You're going to see it keeps our shape of our object perfectly, but what it does is cover it with a nice blanket of mostly quads. So now when I sculpt down the middle, you'll see I can it's a perfectly sculptable surface. The first thing we're going to talk about is resolution. You can see it picked up the object pretty well. It kind of chewed up these corners a little bit, which is okay. You can actually use any number of ZBrush things to clean this up, like the clip brush, the polish brush, even the polish deformer. But if you did want to capture more of that resolution, one thing you can do, let's go ahead and undo out of that so we're back to our original object, is you can crank up this resolution to capture more detail. So if we turn this up to 512 and then hit DynaMesh again, it's going to take it a little bit longer, but we're going to capture a lot more detail. And the reason it took longer is because it's putting so much mesh information onto this object. The only trade-off is, let me turn on Polyframe again, you're getting a lot more geometry to have to deal with. So kind of pick and choose if you want a lower res base mesh that you want to clean up, or if you want to capture more detail but have to deal with more polygons. As you can see, it captured these edges really nicely, and even the faceting from the original object. So pick whichever resolution is best for you to work with. What I'm going to do is go ahead and turn this back down to a resolution of 128, hit DynaMesh. So we're back to our original DynaMesh here. Another thing to keep in mind is the size of your object and the resolution. So actually, let's go ahead and Control Z one more time. So we're back to our original object here. And we'll go up to our subtool, and I'm going to hit the duplicate button. And we'll grab that other object. And using transpose, I'm going to scoot this other object back a little bit behind there. I'm going to scroll down to the deformation menu. And I'm just going to take this size slider and crank it over to the right twice. So we're going to make this object much larger. And we'll go ahead and scoot that right behind the original object. And underneath the geometry menu again, where the DynaMesh sections are, we're actually going to DynaMesh both of these with the same resolution and see what the difference is. So with our big object selected, we're going to hit DynaMesh. And it's actually taking a while because it's DynaMeshing this whole big object at a resolution of 128. Now when we DynaMesh this smaller object, you'll see it does the exact same thing. And if I turn on Polyframe and zoom in and switch between both of these objects, they're both the exact same size quads, but because the other object is so much bigger, it's capturing a lot more detail. And again, that trade-off is the bigger object is 460,000 polys, and the smaller object is about 30,000. So you are capturing more information, but now this one has a lot more resolution, and it's actually catching that faceting as well. But again, we're only at the resolution of 128. So depending on the size of your object, it actually can make the mesh more complex or less complex. So if we take this original object and undo, and we make this, say, a resolution of 32 and hit DynaMesh, you'll see these two meshes are a little bit more comparable and actually detailed captured. So now that we've talked about size and resolution, I'm going to go ahead and get rid of the bigger cylinder here. And on this particular cylinder. I'm going to undo this, and I'm going to crank this resolution up to 256 and hit DynaMesh again. So this is the DynaMesh I'm going to actually use on my decorative helmet. So I'm going to grab my gorilla head, and I'm going to append my newly created DynaMesh here. And I'm going to select my DynaMesh, go down here to the deformation menu, and I'm going to rotate around the y-axis 180 degrees. And using transpose, I'm going to move this back just a little bit. And now I'm ready to start turning this DynaMesh into a decorative helmet.